Hey guys, in today's experiment, we'll try to dissolve this gold ingot in a solution of potassium cyanide. To start, I'll be making potassium cyanide from dry potassium ferrocyanide. To dry it, I heated hydrated salt to about 250 degrees Celsius. The heat removes the water, leaving behind anhydrous potassium ferrocyanide, which has a pale brown color compared to its yellow hydrated form. To obtain potassium cyanide from this salt, I'll add to it the calculated amount of potassium carbonate. I'll mix it well and put this mixture in a muffled furnace at 600 degrees Celsius for some time. At this temperature, a reaction occurs, producing potassium cyanide and a smaller amount of potassium cyanate in a ratio of approximately 5 to 1. After the reaction was complete, which can be determined by the absence of gas bubbles from the melt, I took the melt out of the muffled furnace and poured it into another crucible. The black color you see in the melt comes from elemental iron, a byproduct from the reaction. We can also observe a white salt, which is a mixture of potassium cyanide and cyanate. After the melt cools, it solidifies, making it easy to remove. I dissolve it in water to separate the insoluble iron impurities, which we can collect using a magnet. If we place it on a magnet, all the iron will quickly collect at the bottom of the beaker, which will simplify the task of filtering this solution. After filtering, we obtained a colorless solution of potassium cyanide with an admixture of potassium cyanate. This is not a problem, because potassium cyanate will not have any effect on our experiment. To prove the solution contains cyanide, I'll prepare cyanide indicator paper. First, I mix copper sulfate with ammonia solution to create an ammonia solution of copper sulfate. Then I soak paper in this solution and expose it to hydrogen sulfide gas until it turns brown. After this, we dry it and cut it into pieces. This will be cyanide indicator paper. So, how does it work? This is a fairly selective reaction for cyanide ions. If we place a drop of cyanide solution on the brown paper, the cyanide ions dissolve the brown color, leaving the paper white. This reaction confirms the presence of cyanide. To demonstrate, I'll test various solutions on the paper, and only those containing cyanide ions will cause the brown color to disappear. By adding a few drops of each solution to our indicator paper, we can see that only in the presence of cyanide ions does the brown color of the paper quickly dissolve, and the paper becomes white. The experiment with a copper coin is based on this property of copper sulfide dissolution in the presence of cyanide ions. To obtain copper sulfide on the surface of the coin, I prepared a solution of sulfur and carbon disulfide. Sulfur dissolves very well in it. Then I took a copper coin, or rather this coin consists of zinc, simply coated with copper, and dipped the coin in a solution of sulfur and carbon disulfide. In this solution, copper quickly turns black due to the formation of black copper sulfide on its surface. Now you have a black penny that cannot be washed off with water. Now, if we add a few drops of a solution containing cyanide ions to this coin, the coin will turn copper color again. Well, now let's move on to dissolving gold in potassium cyanide. First, I'll demonstrate the process of dissolving gold using gold foil as an example. The mass of one leaf of such foil is 14 mg. If we just try to dissolve gold in a solution of potassium cyanide, then such a reaction will last a very, very long time. Gold dissolves in potassium cyanide according to the equation. As we can see, oxygen is needed to dissolve gold, or at least air. Now I lower a tube into the test tube and bubble air through the solution until the gold dissolves. It took about 25 minutes to dissolve the gold. Now let's compare it. Instead of air, we bubble pure oxygen. In this case, we only needed 9 minutes. Will gold dissolve faster if azonated oxygen is used instead of oxygen? Let's compare. It really took a little less time with azonated oxygen. It turns out that azonated oxygen is the best option. Now let's try to dissolve not foil in potassium cyanide, but this gold ingot. This sample of gold is 100 times thicker than foil and 7 times heavier. This is 100 mg of pure gold. And now I'll place this ingot in 10 ml of a 2% solution of potassium cyanide, through which I'll pass pure oxygen. Based on the reaction equation, this amount of gold should dissolve in this amount of solution. After 30 minutes, I remove the ingot and weigh it. Judging by the scale readings, we managed to dissolve 38 mg in half an hour. I continued the process, but the dissolution slows significantly. Our gold ingot had noticeably lost its original appearance, but had lost almost no weight, only 2 mg. Then, after more than an hour of dissolution in potassium cyanide at room temperature, the gold didn't change at all in mass and appearance. I replaced the cyanide solution with a fresh one, and again dissolved the gold for more than an hour. This time, after removing the ingot, you can clearly see that in some places the gold has dissolved and micro holes have formed. I'm sure that this is a good sign that the ingot has been lost in mass. And indeed, on the scales, we see less than 1/3 of the initial mass of the ingot. However, then the ingot stopped dissolving so quickly, and I had to dissolve it for more than 10 hours. And even heat the solution a couple of times. In the end, I managed to dissolve a gold ingot using a 2% solution of potassium cyanide 2 times and heating. Although in industry a process of dissolving gold in cyanide can take weeks. To prove that the gold dissolves in the cyanide solution, I placed a zinc ingot in it. Since zinc is more active than gold, it displaces it from the solution, becoming covered with pure gold. This is the zinc with a gold coating I took out of our solution after less than 5 minutes. It It's obvious that the layer of gold coating the zinc is very thin and can be very easily erased with sandpaper. Thanks for watching, guys, and thanks for leaving comments. I hope you enjoyed the video. A huge thank you to all my patrons who helped me to make experiments like this possible. And if you are not among them yet, then be sure to consider this opportunity. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you have not already done it yet, so you don't miss the next video where we use pure potassium cyanide to obtain cyanogen. See you in the next video.